All right, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Market. It's early spring. First thing coming in is asparagus, beautiful, crisp asparagus. Let me give you some nice tips on how to get this cooked right without overdoing it. First, I'm gonna start by breaking the ends off. The asparagus will break just at the right point. Try to break it right at the very end, and it'll pop off just at the right point so you get rid of the woody part, and the rest is really good to go. We're gonna go ahead. This recipe calls for cutting these into little strips. So I'm going to cut these on a bias. Now I could either drop these in boiling water like this or put them into a steamer as such. Either way, they're going to cook really fast. It depends on the asparagus. 1 minute, 3 minutes, that's all it's going to take. And when they're done, we're going to shock them in cold water. All right, it's been about 3 minutes. Bring this ice water over here. The asparagus is going to keep cooking. We want to stop it cooking quickly. So we're going to take this, put it right into the ice water. Stir this around. I'm going to stir it around here. It's going to sit in here for a couple of minutes. It'll chill out really nice, and then we could either serve it cold or warm. Come up in a couple minutes here. We're going to whip this up and make spicy asparagus and peppers. Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. We're gonna take that early spring asparagus, show you how to make it just right. First, I start by steaming it or boiling it. It doesn't need but a couple minutes. Asparagus cooks surprisingly fast. Steam it into a basket here, 2-3 minutes, or in boiling water, and then right into ice water. What that does is it stops the cooking quickly. And if you stop that cooking, it won't get mushy, it won't get squishy. And then I've also got some peppers. I did some nice bell pepper strips here for color. Put them in that ice water, hold them in there. It also retains the color, so they stay beautiful, bright color like this. So I've got the wok going here. Get that heated up a little bit, and I've also toasted some sesame seeds. Just white sesame seeds in the pan, just a few minutes. Stay near and keep shaking them so they don't stick to the pan and burn. Then we're gonna mix in here. I've got some sesame oil and some soy sauce, and then a little bit of this hot oil. You can do this, some of it has the chilies in it sometimes they don't, but nice spicy oil like that. And I just add just a little bit of this agave syrup. You could skip this if you like, but just a little bit to temper that spiciness. These all whip together. I could make this really simple and just toss this asparagus and peppers right in some of this sauce here. Just toss them together really quick, a little bit of sesame seed, and serve it just like that. But I want to do it hot. So let's take it and heat up the wok. Add just a quick drizzle of oil to the wok. I better get the fan going. A little drizzle of oil into the wok. I'm going to throw the asparagus in there and some of the peppers. Oh yeah, nice and hot. That's the way I like it. A little bit of the soy sauce, a little bit of the hot pepper oil, touch of the agave. I'm gonna whip this up. All right, a little bit of sesame seed in here too. Oh, we got one more asparagus that wants to get in there. Since it's been fully cooked already, it goes really fast. We're just warming it up and getting a nice little sear on it. And I'm gonna pair this with a nice piece of fish. I start with a nice piece of striped bass. This is locally raised right here in Colorado, sustainably raised using geothermal ponds so that it doesn't do any damage to the environment. I gave it a quick sprinkle of my Taste of Tokyo rub, or you could just give about any seasoning you want in there. Just a little salt and pepper would be fine. And about 3-4 minutes per side and it's done. Give it a couple more minutes here. All right, we don't need that anymore. So this fish fillet is done about right. I probably spent 7-8 minutes cooking this. Slide it off onto the top of our vegetables. Beautiful. Now at this point, I'm gonna taste and see, maybe just a little bit more of this sauce. Drizzled on here, and this sauce would also be just great with the fish. Okay, And there we have it. Spicy asparagus and peppers with a nice seared piece of fish. You can get all these recipes at digincolorado.com. Go ahead and dig in.